there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon.
Question number 1. The 31st Konark Festival is being organized by which state in December 2020? Option 1. West Bengal. Option 2. Orissa. Option 3. Jharkhand. Option 4. Madhya Pradesh. The correct answer is Orissa. The 31st Konark Festival being organized by Orissa Tourism began on the 2nd of December 2020. The event showcased the best of India's traditional and classical dance forms, besides offering interesting insights into the rich cultural heritage of the country. Leading exponents and dance enthusiasts of almost all classical dance forms of India will take part in the 5-day classical dance carnival. Question number 2. In December 2020, the Environment and Forest Ministry has decided to set up how many vulture rescue centers alongside the existing vulture conservation breeding centers? Option 1, 2, option 2, 3, option 3, 4, option 4, 5. The correct answer is 4. The Environment and Forest Ministry has decided to set up 4 vulture rescue centers alongside the existing vulture conservation breeding centers. These would be established near VCBCS of the city, Pinjore in Haryana, Hyderabad in Telangana, Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh and Rani in Assam. The population of 3 resident species of vultures fell by more than 90% during the mid-90s. Question number 3. Which of the following claimed the top spot on Yahoo's annual list of the most searched films and TV shows of the year? Option 1. Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma. Option 2. Jijaji Chaat Par Hain. Option 3. Khichdi. Option 4. Crime Patrol. The correct answer is Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma. Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma claimed the top spot on Yahoo's annual list of the most searched films and TV shows of the year. Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma beat out the likes of Big Boss and Mirzapur. The list, unveiled in December 2020, also includes mythological epics Mahabharat at the number 2 spot and Ramayana at the number 4 spot. Question number 4. In December 2020, which of the following has inked a long-term strategic partnership with American Express to offer a range of benefits for buyers in India? Option 1. OnePlus. Option 2. Oppo. Option 3. Samsung. Option 4. Huawei. The correct answer is OnePlus. OnePlus has inked a long-term strategic partnership with American Express to offer a range of benefits for buyers in India. The new partnership would provide always-on exciting cashback offers for customers. 10% cashback is provided for product categories listed on OnePlus.in for customers who purchase a product with a minimum listed price of 40,000 rupees. Question number 5. Mahashay Dharampal Gulati passed away in December 2020. He was the owner of which of the following brands? Option 1. Everest. Option 2. Rajesh Masala. Option 3. Badshah Masala. Option 4. MDH. The correct answer is MDH. Mahashay Dharampal Gulati, the owner of the iconic spice brand MDH Mahashayandi Hatti, passed away in December 2020. Dharampal Gulati of MDH, fondly called Dadaji and Mahashay Ji, was born in 1923 in Sialkot, Pakistan. Dharampal Gulati joined his father's spice business in Sialkot. He moved to India after partition and opened a shop in Delhi's Karol Bagh.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon.
Question number 6. In December 2020, the cabinet of which state has cleared a proposal to rename all residential colonies having caste-based names? Option 1. Gujarat. Option 2. Maharashtra. Option 3. Bihar. Option 4. Punjab. The correct answer is Maharashtra. Maharashtra cabinet has cleared a proposal to rename all residential colonies having caste-based names. The decision to rename these localities was taken to maintain social harmony and national unity. Caste-based names such as Mahavada, Bordwada, Mangwada, Dorwasti, Brahmanwada, Mali Gulli are commonplace, but they are unbecoming in a progressive state like Maharashtra. Question number 7. Which birth anniversary of first President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, is being observed in December 2020? Option 1. 131st. Option 2. 133rd. Option 3. 135th. Option 4. 137th. The correct answer is 133rd. The 133rd birth anniversary of first President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, is being observed on the 3rd of December 2020. He served as the president from 1950-1962. Dr. Rajendra Prasad became an active part of India's freedom struggle and participated in grassroots level movements such as non-cooperation movement. After independence, Prasad was elected as President of the Constituent Assembly of India. Question number 8. Who has set up a task force for preparing a roadmap on imparting technical education in mother tongue? Option 1. Ramesh Pokhriyal, Nishink. Option 2. Subramanian Swami. Option 3. Piyush Goyal. Option 4. Narendra Modi. The correct answer is Ramesh Pokhriyal, Nishink. Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal, Nishink, has set up a task force for preparing a roadmap on imparting technical education in mother tongue. The task force set up under the chairmanship of Amit Khare, Secretary, Higher Education, will take into consideration the suggestions made by various stakeholders and will submit a report in a month. Mr. Pokhriyal added that no language will be imposed on any student, but enabling provisions should be made so that bright students are not deprived of technical education due to lack of knowledge of the English language. Question number 9. Who assumed the charge as 27th Director General Border Roads, DGBR, in December 2020? Option 1. Arun Goyal. Option 2. Prakash Rathore. Option 3. Om Prakash Gupta. Option 4. Rajiv Chowdhury. The correct answer is Rajiv Chowdhury. Lieutenant General Rajiv Chowdhury assumed the charge as 27th Director General Border Roads, DGBR, on the 1st of December 2020. He was holding the appointment of ADGLWNE in QMG's branch at Integrated Headquarters of Ministry of Defence Army before this. He was also nominated as Exercise Director of X-Force 18, a multinational exercise involving 18 countries on humanitarian mine action, HMA, in 2016. Question number 10. In December 2020, which state has chosen option 1 to meet the revenue shortfall arising out of GST implementation? Option 1. Jharkhand. Option 2. Bihar. Option 3. Chhattisgarh. Option 4. Punjab. The correct answer is Chhattisgarh. Government of Chhattisgarh has chosen option 1 to meet the revenue shortfall arising out of GST implementation. The number of states which have favored option 1 has gone up to 27. Under the terms of option 1, the states are entitled to get unconditional permission to borrow the final installment of 0.50% of gross state domestic product GSDP out of the 2% additional borrowings.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel and also press this bell icon.